Hi everyone, welcome to Monster Maidens. I'm Satine Phoenix, and you are visiting my channel to watch me draw pictures of ladies, monster ladies from the Monsters Manual. Basically, I have a collection of Monsters Manuals, and I will be flipping through them for the next, I don't know, year? I'm gonna try to do this every day, maybe every other day. I will see how it goes. This is my very first drawing for Monster Maidens. This is a were-tiger. One of my friends drew me as a satyr yesterday. His name's Coop, really cool artist. So I'm actually drawing his girlfriend, Stephanie, as a were-tiger. She likes tigers. So it was appropriate. On the left side, you can see a little sketchbook. So I'm actually drawing from a reference thumbnail that I drew in my sketchbook. It starts off the thumbnail, get it on the paper with a pencil, and that's what you're seeing right here. So I have this references to my Dungeons & Dragons experience. I guess I'll go back. I have an addiction to Dungeons & Dragons. I've been playing it for 17 years, and I've tried to play other games. They just don't connect with me the way Dungeons & Dragons do. So what I'm going to do for Monster Maidens is tell you about the monster that I'm drawing, and either tell you about how I would use them in a campaign or how I have used them in a game before as a player or a dungeon master. So this particular one is a hybrid lycanthrope were-tiger. And when I first started playing in about 95, my dungeon master would let me play lycanthropes. And it was really fun. It kind of, I don't know, filled my imagination more. So it was really, I mean, if he would have said no, I probably would have pitched a fit about it because I really wanted to play a cat person. There was that one cat movie out there, I think it was a Stephen King movie or something. And there were this couple and they were cats, they're sexy. So I wanted to fight things as a cat. You could bite things, you could claw things, and you can also use weapons. So I use daggers and crossbows, kind of like you do in Dungeons and Dragons. This particular adventure that I'm thinking of, I was playing with a minotaur. My friend Jesse was a minotaur, and we were best friends in real life. But for some reason, he wanted to play a cat-hating minotaur. So our characters were constantly bickering and fighting and smelling each other, and just had that like air of not wanting to work together. But we always did, because that's what you do. So I'm drawing her here with clothing that kind of covers her essentials. This particular one, her name is Cyan, and she is owned by a wizard who she is in love with and gives her lots of pretty treasures in exchange for her going to the city and going on little adventures. They're not usually they, as in were-tigers, aren't usually seen very often. And especially not with tigers, but with other like dire tigers, which is what I invented here. I don't know if they exist, they probably do. She just travels with them because she's pretty saucy evil villain, and it's kind of like protection, you know? If she can't do it, then this were-tiger. I mean dire tiger, he probably could. So that's their little story. Yeah, that loincloth isn't really gonna help anything. I mean, cover anything. I'll probably fix that the next drawing I do. Cool thing about these doodles is they're just doodles. They're whatever idea I have in a half hour. This was drawn in 40 minutes. Normally it's drawn in less time, but my camera was wobbly, so I didn't want to shake so much. So I'm actually going really, really slow. So you see the sketchbook on the side, the pencils, inked over the pencils. Right here I'm drawing accents because that'll give the image more dimension. I picked this pose because it was interesting. It shows the legs in a kind of a cat-like angle. I've never actually successfully drew cat paws before, so I'm actually really happy about this. I'm pretty happy with this one. So the last thoughts I have before we close out here is, if you play a Lycanthrop, don't forget the other senses. If you are allergic to cats, be allergic to cats. If you have an affinity to milk, have an affinity to milk if you're playing it. So thank you guys for stopping by. I really appreciate it. And I will see you next time here on Monster Maidens. Thanks, guys. Bye.